Impact on BBC World News. I'm Yelda Hakim. Now, a new scientific study from the University of Essex suggests there could be a link between the length of left index and ring fingers and sexuality. The research found that the amount of testosterone a fetus is exposed to in the womb might have an effect on sexuality. Well, to tell us more about this, I'm joined by scientist and author of the study, Dr. Tuesday Watts. Thank you so much, Dr. Watts, for joining us here on the program. Just tell us about the science behind this. What is your research actually found?
Sure. Well, this research focuses on pairs of genetically identical twins who have different sexual orientations. And so the research was really interested in the factors that could contribute to this really fundamental difference between the identical twins. And so we were looking at prenatal factors, potentially, including testosterone exposure. And the way that we did this was measuring the finger lengths of these identical twins to assess whether there was a difference in the level of testosterone these twins might have been exposed to, which then mapped onto their differences in sexuality.
And so exactly what did you find in that?
So within the pairs of female twins, we found that there were differences in the finger lengths that suggested that the twins who identified as lesbian or non-straight were exposed to or could have been exposed to greater levels of testosterone when they were developing in utero. We didn't find any significant differences between the male twins, so it could be that there really wasn't any real difference in the level of testosterone that the males were exposed to, but there could have been for the females.
Of course, these findings are a broad generalization and don't apply to every individual.
Yeah, I think that's a really important point to make. These findings or the effects were really applied to the average or group level rather than to every single individual. So it wouldn't be the case that you could pick anybody out of a crowd and be able to predict their sexual orientation just by looking at their finger lengths.
So just going forward, how does this bit of research help us understand sexuality?
So these findings are in line with a broader line of research that highlights the potential importance of the prenatal environment in shaping our sexual orientation, and in particular highlighting the role of testosterone exposure in shaping the people we become.
Dr. Tuesday Watts, we'll have to leave it there. Thanks very much for joining us here on the program.
Thank you.
And here to discuss the impact of studies like this, I'm joined by LGBT and human rights campaigner Peter Tatchell. Peter, thanks very much for joining us here on the program. How has a study like this been received by the LGBT community?
Well, many in the community ask the question, why are all these studies into the causes and links with homosexuality, but not the causes and links to heterosexuality? So I think a lot of this research originally began, not this particular study, but a lot of the early research began on the assumption that homosexuality was an anomaly or an aberration that required explanation. And that's obviously quite a negative view. The more positive response from within the LGBT community is that this kind of research does show there's a biological basis to sexual orientation. And if that is the case, and it appears to be, then persecuting LGBT people because of their sexuality is very unfair and wrong. It'd be like persecuting black people because of their skin color. Again, a factor which is rooted in biology. So this will actually help the case for equal rights.
So you think that a study like this could lead to prejudice?
Well, no, I think that the study itself will actually help overcome prejudice, because it will show that, contrary to what homophobic critics say, that it's your wanton, immoral lifestyle that you've chosen and agreed, that is obviously nonsense, because this research shows that sexual orientation is largely influenced in the womb, or significantly influenced in the womb, and that's something over which no one has any control. So the idea that someone should be persecuted for basically a natural inborn trait strikes me as deeply, deeply offensive.
Can it be misused?
Well, potentially, and this is very, very far-fetched, but, I suppose some people might argue that this research could be used by repressive states to identify LGBT people by finger length ratios and then to persecute them. But as you pointed out, of course, this research is it's just an average. I mean, there are many straight people and many gay people who don't fit the pattern. The other option, of course, which is perhaps even more far-fetched, is that maybe mothers could have their hormones tested at an early stage of pregnancy, and that if they had too much testosterone or not enough testosterone, there could be a medical intervention to try and reduce the chances of having a gay child. But I think that's really Dr. Strangelove territory.
As you say, we don't have any evidence of any of these things actually occurring. Peter, thanks very much for joining us here on the programme. And if you're interested in this story, head to our website, bbc.com/news, for all the details.